Mila's touching the bark. Can you feel that, Mila? Yeah, that's the bark of the tree. Yeah. There we go. You got it. Mila's eyes have always been so telling. They light up when she's really interested in something or excited about something. She opens them so wide, I feel like I'm always looking into them. She's probably around close to 4 years old here. And I look at this picture and there's scrapes all down her face. My mom said, you know, she's just kind of a clumsy kid. And I just remember thinking, Mila's never been clumsy. She's incredibly coordinated.
Ready, steady. Whoa, good jumping, Mila.
Between when she was 5 years old and 6 years old, I started realizing just something is really wrong here.
Must hear mommy. That's
why. She's coming.
Mommy.
Okay.
Mommy is mommy.
I started taking her to more and more doctors, and everyone was perplexed. It's like as if she developed and then stopped developing. For two and a half years, I was looking for the answer and being told that there is no answer or that I'm crazy. Eventually, I felt so desperate that I said, I'm putting Mila in the car and bringing her to Colorado Children's Hospital, ER, because I give up. The genetic results came back and they said, it's Batten disease. My first reaction was, finally, I have an answer. But then it hit me that this was just probably one of the worst diagnoses I could have ever received. Children that have Batten disease basically have epilepsy, Parkinson's, blindness, dementia all together. No cure, no treatment. No child has ever lived. I looked at Mila and I thought, how is this possible that she is going to die in like 5 years?
My wife and I were sitting around the kitchen table and she turned to me and said, hey, Tim, have you seen this? And she showed me this post on Facebook about a young family in Colorado that was looking for help. And they needed the expertise of someone who could do whole genome sequencing to help solve a genetic puzzle.
Dr. Yu called me and said, I saw your post. I work at Boston Children's Hospital, and I'm going to help you.
What's your typical sleep schedule?
She usually naps 1 hour during the day.
We found an unusual mutation that turned out to actually explain what was going on with Mila. We came up with the concept to try to design a small piece of synthetic DNA that acts as a little patch that covers up her mutation and essentially makes the cell ignore the mutation.
When Mila falls asleep at night, I put my hands around her head and just feel her energy and think, please just give me some reason to believe that maybe we could stop this. Now we were being told that we actually might have a treatment. Okay, the race is on.
This was a level of difficulty higher than any previous one that Boston Children's had done because we actually had to develop the drug and make it along the way. Drug development is typically the process where you throw 100 drugs down a pipe and one of them comes out the other end, and it might take 15 years to do it. That was not an option for Mila. This is a disease that takes no prisoners. It goes very fast. This was a Hail Mary, so to speak.
This is a situation in which they had designed a drug from scratch, but the drug has never been in animals. It's never been in people. We needed to design and deliver a toxicology study as fast as possible because her rate of decline was month by month. On top of that, we were going to have to work with FDA to ask them special permission to move forward quickly, which was an exception to their usual way of working. It was a tough sell, and we knew it.
Good morning, Mila. Mommy's gonna open your blinds. Good morning, Mila. Good morning.
I wrote a letter to the FDA. And it showed how much she had lost in terms of each of her abilities.
2, 3. And then we're gonna, there we go. We're gonna stretch.
Then I wrote, I think Mila has months left before it's gonna be too late for her to receive this treatment.
It was very clear that we needed to do everything we could as fast as we could, even faster than we could, actually. I sat all these people in a room and I said, don't tell me that for this type of study, it takes 12 weeks. We're not gonna do standard. I need your best.
We were racing against time and Mila was getting worse and worse. The FDA had to approve the drug and that was the biggest step.
In January, we heard from the FDA that we had permission to proceed with the treatment.
The day that she received her first dose, I thought, people told me that it was impossible. They told me that it would take 10 years and that it would never be in time for Mila. And here I am in Boston Children's Hospital, and Mila is receiving an entirely new drug named after her. And I thought, oh my gosh, how is this possible?
We compressed usual toxicology from, I'd say, a solid year to a couple of months.
Hi, Mila. Hi, the big bear.
My porridge.
And if you think about her overall decline, if we had had extra months in there, how much more would she have lost?
This is a disease that normally, over the year that we've been treating Mila, she should have continued to very quickly decline, but we haven't seen her lose much of anything. She's gone from 30 seizures per day down to between 5 and 15, and they're much, much shorter than previously.
Before her treatment began, her hands and her arms had become very tightly locked, which is something that you see with Batten disease. Now she will open her own hands, and if I hold her elbow up a little bit, she will slowly open her fingers and feel something. These are seemingly minor things, but they're enormous in terms of her quality of life.
One of the existential questions that you always ask yourself as a person who's invested in clinical and basic science training is, how do we bring these two things together? With Mila, we were able to do that.
10 years ago, would we have thought that we would design a drug for one person? I don't think so. But now this has become real.
Does that sound, Mila? Do you hear the wind blowing? Yeah.
Yeah.
Ah.
Every single life matters. Saving one person, one child, has an incredible ripple effect. We'll learn a lot from her that will help other people with many other diseases. You know, Mila is the first. This is the future of personalized medicine.